From NASA's Kennedy Space Center in Florida, you're watching live coverage of the 15th SpaceX car resupply mission to the International Space Station. Hi, I'm Stephanie Martin, and thanks for joining us. Today's launch to the station is scheduled for 5:42 Eastern this morning from Space Launch Complex 40 on Cape Canaveral Air Force Station. Today, we have team coverage from Dan Hewitt at Station Mission Control in Houston, Tori McClendon and Mike Curie at NASA's Control Center, SpaceX's Mike Hammersley, directly from their mission control in Hawthorne, California, and Amanda Griffin is standing by with several experts who have hardware and experiments aboard the Dragon. Today's launch will be SpaceX's 15th cargo resupply mission to the International Space Station and the second SpaceX resupply mission of the year. The Dragon spacecraft and Falcon 9 rocket will deliver about 5,900 pounds of research, crew supplies, and hardware to the orbiting laboratory. Today's launch window is instantaneous, meaning SpaceX has only a single second to launch off Space Launch Complex 40 at Cape Canaveral Air Force Station, adjacent to NASA's Kennedy Space Center. We are now 26 minutes away from launch. Let's check in with NASA's Tori McClendon and Mike Curie.
Thanks, Stephanie. I'm Tori McClendon, and with me is Mike Curie.
Good morning, Tori.
Morning.
We are looking forward to today's launch. We're one day removed from an official full moon, and the time of launch is 44 minutes away from sunrise here on Florida's Space Coast. So I'm looking forward to a really probably spectacular view of the Falcon 9 and Dragon as they lift off the launch pad this morning.
Sounds great. We're definitely looking forward to it. And we are actually here live at Hangar AE on Cape Canaveral Air Force Station, which is not far from the launch site of today's Falcon 9 rocket that will lift off from Space Launch Complex 40.
That's right. And you're looking at a live shot of the launch site with the Falcon 9 rocket with gaseous oxygen venting as the rocket is being prepared for launch at 5:42 and 42 seconds a.m. Eastern Time. As Stephanie was mentioning, it's an instantaneous launch window, so 42 seconds after 5:42 a.m. will be the time of launch this morning. At that time, the International Space Station will be over the South Pacific, southeast of New Zealand, at an altitude of 258 statute miles.
That's right, and a launch today would have the Dragon spacecraft that is filled with 5,900 pounds of research, crew supplies, and vehicle hardware being captured by the International Space Station on Monday, July 2nd at 7 a.m. Eastern. The Dragon will then connect to the station's Harmony module.
Launch teams received a weather briefing from U.S. Air Force 45th Space Weather Squadron Officer Mike McAleenan. He's our launch weather officer. He says that we can expect good weather today. Probability of violation is only 10%. That means we're 90% favorable. Light winds, 8 to 10 miles per hour from the southwest. Temperature at the time of liftoff expected to be 76 degrees. The only concerns, the cumulus and anvil cloud rules. But again, at this time, Mike McAleenan is saying that we have thin and high cirrus clouds. There's really not much of a probability of anything happening between now and the time of launch, so it looks like weather is not going to be a concern for us today, Tori.
Sounds great. Teams are also working through the necessary procedures to prepare the Falcon 9 rocket and the Dragon spacecraft for launch, and that includes loading fuel into both stages of the rocket and making sure that all systems are properly checking out. So far, the countdown has progressed toward the timeline. Loading of RP-1 fuel began at T-minus 1 hour and 10 minutes at 4:32 a.m. Loading of liquid oxygen began at T-minus 35 minutes at 5:07 a.m.
So at T-minus 23 minutes, 25 seconds and counting, that is the current status from Falcon Launch Control, Stephanie, and for now we'll send it back to you.